Good morning, students. Welcome to the biology class. We have finished with the first part of the chapter, that is about the diseases. Today we will discuss the second part of the chapter, that is immunity. As we know that daily we are being exposed to the number of undesirable substances, number of harmful substances, number of infectious agents, but we are not having any disease every day. It means something is there in our body which protect us, which fight against these particular unwanted substances. So what is that particular ability, what is that particular system which protect us from that unwanted substances, from the infectious agent, from the foreign particle? That is what called as immunity. So the word immunity has been derived from the Latin word immunis, means to save or free from. Immunity is the ability of an organism to resist or defend itself from the development of disease. So what is immunity? Immunity is basically that ability of our body which protect our body, which prevent our body, which makes our body to resist or defend itself from the various unwanted substances that develop the disease. So to protect ourselves from the disease, our body should have a good ability to resist a disease, and that is what known as the immunity. Thus, immunity forms the defense system of the body, so it is considered to be the self-protecting system of the body against any pathogenic activity inside the body. Such protective system is called as immune system. Nowadays, you can see the number of the patients are there of the coronavirus, but everyone is not being exposed to that particular disease. The reason is the person who are having a better immunity, who are having a strong immunity, they can prevent themselves from that particular disease. The study of immune system and its related aspect is called as immunology. So in this we will study about the immunity. It is that particular system which protect our body from the various unwanted foreign and harmful substances. What is the principle of the immunity? Matlab, on what particular property the immune system works? The immune system has important property to recognize self and non-self. So what do you mean by self and non-self? Self are the substances which are familiar to the body environment or body's own. Means the cell which are being present in our body, the body which is made up of the particular cells, they are the part of the body, they are growing, they are developing. That is what called as a self. The substances which are foreign of origin, which are incompatible to the body environment, they are called as a non-self. So basically the substances which enter our body and they are not compatible with our body, they are considered as in foreign particles, that is known as a non-self. So the immune system has to accept the self and to reject out the non-self. So by this way, our body will be protected from the unwanted substances, from the foreign substances. So this is the basic principle that our immune system can recognize, can distinguish between the self and the non-self substances, or self and non-self cells. Types of immunity. Immunity is of two basic types. Number one is innate or inborn or natural immunity, and number two is acquired or after birth immunity. So one by one we will discuss both the immunities in detail. So first we are going to discuss about innate or inborn or the natural immunity. What is innate or inborn immunity? As the name indicates, it is present from the birth and is inherited from the parents. It is non-specific type of defense. Non-specific means they are not having any particular specific action against about the bacteria, virus, protozoa or any other foreign particle. They are going to behave same with all type of the foreign particles or that of the unwanted substances. So they are non-specific type of defense. It is accomplished by providing the different types of barrier to entry of the foreign agents into our body. So in the innate immunities, we are having the barriers. Barriers का मतलब है रास्ता रोकना. एक के बाद एक barrier है. अगर barrier cross होगा तो next barrier उसे बचाएगा, फिर next, and then ultimately that is considered to be the innate immunity. So after crossing all the barrier, only then the pathogen, the infectious agent or the foreign particle can harm our body. So such type of immunity, which is accomplished by providing the different types of the barrier to the entry of the foreign agents into our body, and they are non-specific, they are present from the birth and is inherited from the parent, that immunity is known as innate or inborn immunity. Types of barriers. So innate immunity consists of four barriers. Number one is physical barrier. Number two is physiological barrier. Number third is cellular barrier. And the last one is a cytokine barrier. So we will discuss each barrier one by one. Next is lines of defense. Our immune system is divided into three lines of defense. Three lines of defense means the first line को cross करेगा तो second line का barrier रोक लेगा और फिर जाके third line को cross करना पड़ेगा. जब ये तीनों line को cross कर देगा means the foreign element will cross three of the lines, only then it will cause a disease to our body. The first line of defense, that is means the external, कि बाहर से ही रोक देना, अंदर बॉडी के अंदर जाने ही नहीं देना, दैट इज व्हाट कॉल्ड एज द फर्स्ट लाइन ऑफ डिफेंस. दैट कंसिस्ट ऑफ टू बैरियर, फिजिकल एंड फिजियोलॉजिकल बैरियर. आफ्टर क्रॉसिंग दैट बैरियर, देन देयर विल बी अ सेकेंड लाइन ऑफ डिफेंस, मींस सेलुलर. जो आपकी बॉडी के अंदर सेल्स हैं वो उस फॉरेन एजेंट को ट्रैप कर लेंगे और आपकी बॉडी को प्रोटेक्ट करेंगे. देन देयर इज अ साइटोकाइनिन बैरियर, मींस दे विल फॉर्म अ नंबर ऑफ द सेल्स व्हिच विल प्रोटेक्ट योर बॉडी फ्रॉम द वेरियस हार्मफुल सब्सटेंसेस. एंड आफ्टर क्रॉसिंग द first line and second line, then there is a third line that is called as acquired immunity, in which we are having a specialized cells which will protect our body from the foreign particles. So first we are going to discuss about the first line of body defense. First line of body defense, that is the physical or anatomical barrier. What is the function of this barrier, or what is the principle of this barrier? These barriers do not allow the pathogens and foreign agents to enter the body. So they won't allow the pathogens or the foreign elements to enter our body. So how they will, they include, number one is skin. As you know, the skin is covered by the horny layer of dead keratinized cell, which does not allow the entry of the foreign agent. As you know, the skin is having a number of dead cells, number of the horny layer. So if any particular foreign particle is being present on the skin, it will be trapped there and it won't enter your body. Number two is nasal hair. So the hair are being present in our nose. They do not allow the large dust particles, because dust particles mein bahut sare infectious agent hote hain aur micro organisms bhi hain. So they will trap, matlab wahi pe reh jayenge, wahi pe uska rasta ruk jayega, and they won't enter your nasal tract, then they won't cause any harmful effect to our respiratory system. The third physical barrier is the mucous membrane. The membrane that line all the internal tract, just a digestive system, respiratory system, urinogenital system, they are having a mucus layer, this is viscous, this is friction na ho. So they prevent the entry of the foreign structures or microorganism into the body tissues. Agar wo jaate hain to wo mucus mein trap ho jate hain, wahan se wo aage nahi ja pate, to wahi ke wahi pe wo खत्म हो जाएंगे. सो द फर्स्ट लाइन ऑफ बॉडी डिफेंस में जो हम फिजिकल एनाटॉमिकल बैरियर में क्या क्या लेते हैं, नंबर वन स्किन, कि स्किन के ऊपर लेयर प्रेजेंट है, जहां पे फॉरेन एजेंट्स वहीं पे खत्म हो जाएंगे. अगर नोज से घुसने की कोशिश करेंगे तो नेजल हेयर उन्हें ट्रैप कर लेगा. अगर कहीं नोज से या कहीं और बॉडी के अंदर जाते हैं तो वहां का म्यूकस मेम्ब्रेन उनको वहीं पे रोक देगा. अगर नेक्स्ट इज योर फिजियोलॉजिकल बैरियर्स, कि अगर समहाउ अगर वो आपके मुंह में चला जाता है तो वहाँ पे दे शुड हैव सम पर्टिकुलर बायोकेमिकल और फंक्शनल लेवल्स विच प्रिवेंट द ग्रोथ ऑफ इनवेडिंग पैथोजेनिक ऑर्गेनिज्म। मतलब फिजियोलॉजिकल बैरियर में दे विल हैव सम बायोकेमिकल सब्सटेंसेस, मतलब कुछ एंजाइम्स होंगे, कुछ सिक्रीशंस होंगी जो कि माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स को ट्रैप कर लेंगे। कैसे? नंबर वन इज एसिड इन द स्टमिक्स। सपोज कि आपने कुछ खाया और खाने के साथ आपका कोई माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म स्टमक में चला गया, और स्टमक में आपको पता है कि वी आर हैविंग द HCl। सो HCl ऑफ द गैस्ट्रिक जूस विल किल द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म एंड मेक्स योर बॉडी फ्री फ्रॉम द इन्फेक्शन। सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट फिजियोलॉजिकल बैरियर। नंबर टू इज सिन सिक्रीशन। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, बिकॉज स्किन दे आर हैविंग द ऑयल ग्लैंड्स, दे आर हैविंग अ स्वेट ग्लैंड्स, एंड नेचुरली दे आर सिक्रीटिंग द ऑयल एंड स्वेट यू नो इट इज अ वेरी सेलाइन नेचर, इट हैज अ वेरी एसिडिक इन नेचर, सो दे आर हैविंग अ लैक्टिक एसिड, दे आर हैविंग अ फैटी एसिड्स विच मेक्स योर स्किन सर्फेस एसिडिक। तो इफ सम हाउ दे विल ट्रैप ओवर देयर, सो दे विल गेट ट्रैप, सो दे विल गेट मेक्स योर स्किन फ्री फ्रॉम द इन्फेक्शन। तो सिंस सिक्रीशन द ऑयल एंड द स्वेट सिक्रीटेड बाय द सेबेशियस ग्लैंड, मीन्स योर ऑयल ग्लैंड एंड स्वेट ग्लैंड ऑफ द स्किन कंटेन फैटी एसिड एंड लैक्टिक एसिड, मेक्स द स्किन सर्फेस एसिडिक। बिकॉज ऑफ द एसिडिक दिस डज नॉट अलाउ द एंट्री ऑफ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स इन टू द बॉडी। So the skin secretion, oil, sweat, they make your skin acidic, and because of that, the entry of the microorganisms can be prevented. Third is saliva, that is in your buccal cavity. It contains a very important enzyme that is known as a lysozyme, which kills the microorganism and does not allow the bacteria to enter the buccal cavity to your digestive system along with the food and water. कि आपके अगर आप food या water में कोई micro organism है तो saliva का lysozyme उसको वहीं पे खत्म कर देगा और आपके digestive system को protect करेगा from the infection. And the third is tears. आपको पता है कि आँख में अगर कुछ चला जाता है तो पानी आता है, और फिर हम कहते हैं कि आंख को अच्छे से धो तो आपकी आंख सही हो जाती है, उसमें इन्फेक्शन नहीं होती है। द रीजन इज द टीयर्स कम्स आउट, तो पानी का मतलब है टीयर्स आना। सो टीयर्स, व्हाट आर टीयर्स? दैट इज दे आर स्लाइटली सेलाइन फ्लूइड। कभी कभी अगर उसका टेस्ट किया हो तो वो नमक जैसा लगता है। फ्रॉम वेयर इट इज सिक्रीटेड, दे आर अगेन हैव अ स्पेशलाइज ग्लैंड फ्रॉम वेयर द टीयर्स कम्स आउट। दे आल्सो कंटेन द सेम एंजाइम दैट इज कॉल्ड एज अ लाइजोजाइम्स विच प्रिवेंट योर आई इन्फेक्शन। सो दीज फोर आर योर फिजियोलॉजिकल बैरियर। सो दे आर हैविंग सम एसिडिक नेचर, सो दे हैव सम पर्टिकुलर एंजाइम विच विल ट्रैप द micro organism and prevent your body from the various infection, that is acid in the stomach, sin secretion, saliva and tears. So first line of defense we are having a physical and physiological barriers, which are just a barrier by which the entry of the micro organisms are being prevented, are being prohibited. When they will cross this first barrier, then the role of the second barrier will come into the existence. So this is all for today. Next lesson will be on the second line of defense. Till then, goodbye, stay safe, stay happy and stay healthy. Thank you.